This is the face of the future of Baltimore. Wide-eyed with curiosity, open to adventure, shining with hope. We've seen a lot of these faces over the years at Living Classrooms. Here, children learn by doing, and we work to transform the lives of young people in Baltimore. By helping to break the cycle of poverty and showing them the wonders of the world outside of the grim reality of our city. But the fact is, the city is their home. Just a few blocks from Living Classrooms in the Inner Harbor is a world of grit, crime, and poverty, and the ever-present threat of violent crime.
So much drug activity, with children being shot on the street and mothers out there screaming and hollering and crying. It was the worst place that you wanted to live.
In order to truly transform the lives of inner city children, we had to do more than take them out of the world they live in. We had to totally transform that world. One block, one school, one community center, one playing field at a time. And that's when the East Side Children's Target Investment Zone was born.
You know, when we started this in 2007, we only had one school, Crossroads. Now we have another one. We took over the second worst performing school in the state of Maryland, Commodore John Rogers.
When you walked around the building, the facility was not in great shape. There was graffiti on the walls. There was broken furniture. It didn't really feel like a place where students can learn. Didn't feel like a place where students would want to be. I know it felt like a place that I didn't want to be. Starting from day one, when the community knew that Living Classrooms was going to be the partner that was overseeing the success of the school, we had so many families just come in and enroll at the school. We were again projected for 225 students. On day one, we had over 400 students. There was word of mouth around the neighborhood, and we ended up with 500 students. Right now, we're at 560 students. We have more students coming in than going out.
Without this school, I'm not certain if my children would be courageous enough to want to go to school and to want to be excited as they are.
Now we have the Powerhouse, which is a abandoned firehouse that we renovated.
We pick up students every day at 3 o'clock from City Springs Elementary Middle. We walk them down 2 blocks to the Powerhouse where they are served supper. The next thing we do is we break down into groups and we go into the classrooms from first through eighth grade where homework is done. And then for an hour, we work on literacy. And the last hour of the day is when our students get to have fun. That's the time where our students are able to do our Believe in Music project, and we also have our yoga piece. We also have karate. We also have STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So we became a community resource center in a sense, because we are a community center and a multi-purpose center. And the whole goal here was to bridge the gap in this community.
At the Powerhouse, we have a learning center where we're teaching financial literacy. We believe that financial literacy is the key to economic well-being, which also parallels into health well-being.
Without the Powerhouse or Living Classrooms, this community would be dead. Because there's nothing here for them but this Powerhouse. And this is what most of our kids look forward to on a daily basis. But they thrive for Monday through Friday because they know we got somewhere to go. And it's nothing but love here at the Powerhouse.
What we give to the kids is our support, 100% support, and to the parents. You know, they're in our hands from 3 to 6 every day. They know that they're getting their homework done, they're getting activities done that need to be done to help them with their schoolwork.
A lot of places you go aren't parent involved, and I can come up here and take all kinds of classes that they offer. We do all kinds of enrichment activities with them. We were just here Saturday for the health fair.
We also have students who have graduated out of the program within the last 2 years who want to come back to volunteer. They want to come back to be a youth worker and tutor the younger children. And I also noticed that those students are not the ones hanging on the corners doing nothing.
Patterson Park Youth Sports and Education Center started with an idea between Baltimore City Public Schools, Living Classrooms, and a lot of private public funders that came together and decided to create green space for the schools and the community in this area.
Before I played lacrosse, I was always getting in trouble. Spent most of my time in the hallway, not in class. Now that I'm playing lacrosse, it helped me stay focused on my goals.
It provides us an opportunity to and a forum to invest in our kids in a way that just wasn't possible before.
Never had a feel to actually say that it's ours and like we appreciate it.
It's more about the chance to choose. Choose to be an athlete, choose to be an amazing student, but most kids in this area don't have the opportunity to choose.
So it's a real gift to the community, the schools in the neighborhood, and the entire area.
It's not okay just to spend time and energy on our children. We must understand it's about the entire family and making a difference for all of them so we can make a difference for the entire Baltimore community. I think Project Serve is one of the stronger reentry programs. Too often we write off adults who have served their time, and too often what we do when we write them off is we contribute to the continuation of the very problems that we're trying to solve.
I get a joy to see these guys come out of prison and then move on and get better jobs and just stay on the street and just change from what they've been doing for all these years.
Well, Living Classrooms are giving people a chance, giving them something to do, whereas they don't have to come out here and steal or sell drugs. They can earn their own money by doing the right thing for the right reason.
We know Project Serve makes a difference in terms of you can look at the employment opportunities they've gained and look at them not returning to incarceration as making a difference for our community. And that's the kind of investment that we need more of.
In the target investment zone area of East Baltimore, we are able to reach 1,500 children, youth, and young adults a day with our education program and workforce development, our work in the schools, our work in the community, working in partnership with corporations, foundations, individuals volunteering, with the city government, state government, federal funding. This whole combined effort will enable us to be successful. This is a significant effort where day in and day out, if we provide Living Classroom support, energy, and programming, we can help to break the cycle of poverty. And it's something we're committed to for many years to come.
So as you can see, block by block, school by school, community center by community center, playing field by playing field, Living Classrooms Eastside Children's Target Investment Zone is radically transforming the world these children and their parents live in. The future they can look forward to, and ultimately transforming the city itself. Look at us.
We are the face of Baltimore's
future.
I'm the face of Baltimore's future.
These are the faces that you can help keep open and filled with hope.